What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabbit here, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to mine Conflux to the Cryptex mining pool. We're also going to go through a bunch of things that Cryptex has within their ecosystem, which I was unaware about, and it's actually a lot of cool features going on here. There's two separate ways that you can mine in Windows. One of them is almost like a consistent comparison with NiceHash, but the availability to be paid out in Bitcoin, USDT, bank transfers, and so on using their app itself. Or you can simply point to the mining pool in general. We're also going to look at some ecosystems of GPU ROIs that's only mineable on their pool. So there's a lot of things going on here. Stay tuned, and I'm going to help you mine Conflux. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go through the Cryptex app. This is the fastest and easiest way to probably get up and mining Conflux or any of the most profitable coins that Cryptex does support. First thing you are going to need to do is make an account, go to the register button. It's pretty simple, self-explanatory right at the get-go, and then download the app and extract that. So once you do download it and install it, then it's going to begin the benchmarking process. As we can see here, it's going to go through a bunch of different algorithms and everything that Cryptex does support, and then get kind of some hash rates and everything, and then it's going to profit switch based on all your benchmarks, pretty much what we do see with NiceHash. Now once you do get it all done benchmarking and everything, it will then open up and begin mining. So now we can see that this is actually saying I should get around $220 per month, or $7.36, now $7.39 per day. And it is using my CPU, which looks like it's mining Zeph, and is using my RTX 4090, which is currently pointing towards Octopus. So just like NiceHash here, it is profit switching based on all the coins in the Cryptex pool, and then it is gonna pay us out. Now, once you do start getting a balance, you go into your dashboard here. Here you can see I don't really have any yet, I just started, but you can request a payment. And this is a pretty big feature I think a lot of people might like, as you can then withdraw in Bitcoin, Ethereum, you know, Tron USD for cheaper fees, Binance USDT, and then, you know, various other methods as well. And it looks like instead of just Bitcoin, you have a lot of options to withdraw your balances to different various wallets and bank accounts. Now, one thing I wish it had is a minimize button. I don't see one anywhere that I can actually use, so maybe that'll be added in. Also, for the benchmarking here, if at the start it gave us like a 20-second warning before it switched each algorithm, we could probably bring up like LOL Miner GUI here and then adjust some overclocking settings and stuff before it benchmarked, because I just went based on stock here, and it's not really getting the maximum hash rate and efficiency numbers that you should be doing during the benchmarking process. But it does look like, just like with NiceHash here, you can rerun the benchmark. So I'm assuming you can just turn certain algorithms on and off and then benchmark each one individually. I got a lot of testing I got to do, but this is an interesting platform that I never really played with previously. Also, it looks like you can set extra config arguments in the individual miners as well if you want to overclock it from within the mining software, depending on the coin. So maybe you have to set it for each algorithm or something as well. But it looks like you have a lot of features here to play with, and it's gonna take a long time to really figure out everything here. And then if you don't wanna mine anymore, you can simply just turn it off or hit the X button and not have to worry about it. But it's a nice handy little system that they do have here. So yeah, I'm starting to actually kind of like this. So that is probably one of the fastest and easiest ways to get up and running for mining Conflux. If you want to use the app, I will have a link down in the description. Now, if you want to mine directly to the pool itself, simply go up to the top of the webpage here at Cryptex and hit mining pools. We will then get a list, as you can see here, of all the accepted coins, which is the same coins that was all benchmarked within the app. So now we're going to pick Conflux here, hit start mining, and this will give us everything we need to connect to the pool by itself. Here's our host name, our ports, and then a little wallet format with our worker and wallet name. So in order to mine Conflux, you're going to need yourself a wallet. So head on over to the Conflux website, click on create wallet, and that will ask you to add this into your Google Chrome or Brave browser, whatever you do use, the Fluent wallet here. Once you've done that, write down your seed phrase, do everything you got to do, and then simply copy your wallet address right here. As you can see, I am loaded up with zero Conflux, so that sucks. I wish I had a lot more, but that's how you get your wallet here. This is your mining address that you're going to need to copy to within your miner to get paid to this wallet. Next up, you are going to need a miner. Now, I don't even think AMD has support from any of the miners, so you are only going to be able to use NVIDIA GPUs with at least 8 gigabytes of memory. So a lot of the A2000s will not work on Conflux unless you got the 12 gigabyte versions. But I'm going to go with Regal Miner here, so navigate to here and download the latest version for Windows or Linux, depending what you're mining on. This beginning guide is a Windows tutorial, so I'm going with Regal 1.11 in Windows. So once you do download Regal Miner, just scroll to wherever you did extract it, and you will see CFX. So we're going to click on that, right click, and hit the edit button. And this is where we're going to put in all our commands for mining. So here it's saying it's defaulted to Wooly Pooly. I'm just going to change this over to Cryptex because we're not going to be using Wooly Pooly. So Cryptex right there. And now we have the two semicolons missing right here. That means it's going to use this command line right here. Once you put them in, it's going to eliminate this. And now it's not going to mine to nothing because they both have them. So I'm going to get rid of this. So say you set it up for multiple pools or something. Then you simply remove like I just did on whatever pool you want to use. But here we're setting this up for Cryptex. So now I'm just going to come into the Cryptex mining pool, minimize this, and I want to copy this stratum right here. So I'm going to copy this, right click, copy, bring up our bat file here, and I'm going to paste that in right here. So we're going back, paste that there. And now we need our ports. So now we're going to use port. I'm going to use TCP. So I'm just going to go with the 4.7s right there. So we're going to go like that, 1, 2, 3, 4. And now we need our wallet address. So I'm simply going to click up top here, go into my Fluent wallet again, copy that wallet address, bring up our bat file, and I'm going to input that right here. Now the Cryptex pool does say use your worker name followed right behind it, but Regal says use it in your password log. So here you can see I have 4090 house burned down. I was using that on NiceHash to test it out. I'm going to adjust this to the 4090 only as your worker name right here, and we're going to see if this works. So now I'm just going to simply save this, and we're good to go. So we saved that. I'm going to close it. Now I'm going to set some overclock settings. Now within Windows, I like to use the LOL Miner GUI. Now I'm not sure 100% what overclock settings to use yet. I'm in my workstation. I can't really see my power. So I got to do a lot of tests on this 4090. So I'm going to pull it out sometime here. But I'm going with a core offset of 300 and a memory offset of plus 1000. Now going into hashrate.no, it doesn't have any locked core. And it's not telling me to put in an offset, but you do save a bit of power adding in an offset. So I always run with at least a 300 offset on all of my NVIDIA GPUs. And it is telling us if you're in Linux, so Hive OS or something, you will use 2000 megahertz as that is doubled from what you would use in Windows. And in this case, I'm using 1000, which we just seen, and we're locking our power limit to 280, which we have right there. So I'm just going to apply those OCs, and now I'm simply going to run this bat file, and we should begin mining Conflux to Cryptex. All right, so navigate to your bat file here and simply double click it. Now we can see we are starting to mine. We are connecting to the Cryptex mining pool. It's going to load the DAG and everything, and then after about 2 minutes or so, we should be detected at the pool. All right, so now you can see we are detected at the pool. We are at 71.58 mega hash, 4.84 mega hash on the average. Obviously, we got to wait longer to get our full hash rate and numbers. And down below, our worker name, the 4090, is working. So everything is looking good on the pool side and Windows side. So now let's move on over to Hive OS. All right, so now we're in Hive OS. We're going to go into our wallets here and simply add a wallet because we need a wallet address to mine to. So I'm going to go coin and ticker here, CFX. Conflux will pop up here, and we got to paste our wallet address into here. So I'm just going to go into my Fluent wallet here, copy my wallet address right here, and we're just going to call this test video, like so, and create that wallet. So now we have our wallet in Hive OS. We got to set up this flight sheet. So I'm going to come into here. Now we're just going to go CFX. Load that wallet. You can see I have multiple wallets here, so we're going to go with test video. That's what we just named this. pool. I don't know if Cryptex, oh, it is here by default, so that makes things even easier. So we're just going to click on Cryptex here. We're going to pick the global server. It'll pick the closest stratum to you. I think it's the only one they have anyway, so we're just going to apply that. As for our miner, we're going to go with Regal Miner here, and then we're just going to put in a flight sheet name. So I'm going to go test video Cryptex, and then we got to set up our miner. Make sure everything is in here. So here it is saying wallet.worker name. Now I am going to put the worker name over here and remove it because that is what Regal Miner does prefer, which we saw in Windows. Password we don't need. I'm going to eliminate that. And now I'm simply going to apply these changes and create that flight sheet. Once it's done doing that, I'll scroll up, go into our workers here, click on our Octominer, then enter my flight sheet. And then scroll all the way down and then just enable that by hitting this rocket ship here. We are sending this flight sheet to the moon and we're going to kick all our GPUs in. So overclock settings here, I don't have them set in the miner. I got them all set here, so I don't have any core offsets, but I am locking my cores here. As you can see at 1605 on the 3060 Ti's, we got a memory of 2000 and a power limit of 210. I could probably bring the power limit down a bit. I got a lot of testing to do on a lot of these algorithms right now, but for a baseline reference, you can just use something that was close to Ethereum based. And jumping back into the pool, we can see we now have two workers online. Our hash rate spiked and the Octominer name is working, so it is now detected. Everything is working in both Windows and HiveOS. So the Cryptex mining pool is a PPS plus pool. What does that mean? You're always paid based on 100% luck. You may have mined on various pools and they're not finding any blocks, so you're not really getting any type of payout. You're always going to get a payout whether the pool finds blocks or it doesn't. But keep in mind, this will work in reverse. As if they're having a very good luck day, you are not going to see more rewards like you would various on other pools. But this is a nice and consistent ecosystem where you'll always get paid around that 100% mark. Another interesting resource that Cryptex actually has is the best GPUs for mining in terms of ROIs and profits and paybacks and so on. And this is based on all the coins that their pool does support as well. As we can see, Conflux, Iron, Nexa, Ravencoin, Ergo, ETC, FW. It'll show you your month, your payback periods, ROI. So here you can simply see, you can sort it by fastest ROI, and it's looking like the CMP40HX cards are only a 48-day ROI for people that care about the ROI factor. You can show your monthly profits, and then for the longest ROIs, what is this? The A100, that is an expensive GPU, but that's over 4,000 days. That's absolutely insane. What is the price of this thing? Like $6,000. Wow, that is crazy. But you can see there are some GPUs that are under 2 months. That's pretty crazy right now in form of the CMP40HX. It looks like the CMP50HX is in second place with only a 60-day ROI at $179. So you can go over and sort by hash rate too on various coins, maximize profit per coin and GPU. It looks like the RTX 4090, which is what we see everywhere, is the dominant card in terms of revenue and profits here. But there's a lot of interesting features that Cryptex has within its own ecosystem. All right, guys, so hopefully this video did help you up and get up and running to mining Conflux to the Cryptex mining pool and exploring a lot of different ways that you can actually mine and look at various information regarding GPUs within the whole Cryptex ecosystem. This is very interesting, and I don't think there's any other pools that actually do everything that Cryptex is doing. Thank you for checking out this video, guys. I will see you on the next one. Rabbit out.